In this video, let's build this super simple 100 watt LED light which can be even used for recording YouTube videos. So without any further ado, let's build it. This video is sponsored by Banggood.com. For start, we need a 100 watt LED. But we cannot just use any 100 watt LED, we need one with good CRI rating. You can find all the parts used in this project in the video description. Now this 100 watt LED needs a heatsink. So I just got one with the mounting holes for the LED. Before mounting it though, make sure to use thermal compound for better heat transfer. Once that was done, just firmly press the LED on the thermal compound and then use 10mm long M3 bolts for mounting the LED onto the heatsink. After which, we need to find the polarity of the LED, which is marked on the LED but still confusing which terminal is which. So just put the multimeter on continuity mode and test the LED to find the proper polarity. After which, just solder some wires which will be later on used. Now for focusing the light beam, you can either use 120 degree or 60 degree lens. I personally prefer 120 degree for more evenly spread out light which will cover more area. First of all, place the reflector cone on the LED, then place the lens over it. Now use some 20mm long M3 bolts to secure the LED with the bracket. Now for better heat dissipation, I will recommend adding a fan to the heatsink. I just used this 90mm computer fan which was attached using some M3 bolts. However, these fans have 3 wires. Red and black are for 12V power and blue or yellow in some cases is for the sensor, which we don't need. So just cut it off. Once that was over, I used this 4mm thick acrylic and used some hot glue to secure the heatsink onto it. Now for controlling the power to the LED, we need a circuit with constant current driver, which are required for these high power LEDs, which are readily available in the market. But before connecting it, I removed this tiny potentiometer and replaced it with bigger one of the same value, so it's easier to control. And again using some hot glue, I secured it on the acrylic plate. Now for the input, I used this XT60 connector and connected it along with the fan cable at the input side of the board. So fan and the circuit receive 12V power from the battery. And at the output side of the board, we connect the LED, and with that being done, this project was complete. Now just connect a 12V supply at the input using XT60 connector or a battery like a lithium polymer one and you are ready to shine.